lot when I'm not in drag as well, but in my spare time I like to go out for dinners, movies, just catch up with friends. Normally, most of the time I just want to stay at home and be comfortable in my trackies.
Going, my downtime's got to be movies. Not just movies, actually, viewing in general. I love to watch what I love to watch. A good movie, a period movie. Shocking geek here, but I love a documentary. History documentaries in particular. And if I get onto a good series, watch out. I'm there for where to go.
When I'm a man, like, I work quite a lot. When I'm not working, I like to eat, I like to go out and eat. Sleep, I love sleep. I do study, but maybe not as much as I should. And I just like to go out and eat, to be honest, hang out with my friends, because I don't get much time. And then that's good enough for me. And I go away occasionally, maybe not as much as I'd like, but yeah, I'm trying to plan more things to do outside of this gay circle, but we'll see what happens.
I have a lot of hobbies outside of my drag life. I love to run. I run down the Yarra 2 or 3 times a week. I'm a big meditator as well, because I'm very much into like being zen and sort of like mental health and all that kind of stuff, so I meditate a lot. What else do? I read. I love true crime novels, especially Australian true crime. One day I would love to write my own Australian true crime novel. What else do I do? I play with my pussy quite a lot. He plays fetch, so I love watching that. Yeah.
When I'm a man, what do I like doing? I like exercising, because I'm type 1 diabetic, so I have to, every 10 years you lose 10% of muscle, so you must keep the muscle up, because the more muscle you have, the better the insulin works for type 1 diabetes. So I like doing the 1,000 steps, I like hiking, I like walking, I like gardening, I love movies, music, and catching up with close circles of good friends. And hearing, seeing how their lives are going, and sharing stories, and reminiscing, and talking about future plans, and travelling. I'm about to go over to America to visit a friend of mine who I've been friends with for 23 years. He's a makeup artist for one of the ladies on The Real Housewives of Miami, actually. So I'm going to see him, then going to catch up with friends who I've met all through drag in Las Vegas, and then we're going to LA for a couple of days. So this is what drag does, and create a real sisterhood, a brotherhood. It's very, very nice. Our own sort of family. Sadly, some do pass away, and some you have fights with, which is really silly, but that's life.
I like going to the theatre. Again, if I had a boyfriend, I'd go more often. But I do like going to see theatre. I'd like to travel a little bit more, and just having a good time.
I used to travel a lot. I had in my day job, I used to travel overseas buying menswear. I did it. I used to go to London, Paris, and Milan. I did that for 6 years, twice a year. And prior to that, I'd always travelled overseas. I haven't had a holiday for a long time, actually. I'm not a big computer nerd, but I am on Facebook. I'm very slow on it, but I'm getting there. I'm on the computer a little bit. I don't have any hobbies as such. Basically, what I was doing was just making costumes, or helping make costumes with Rita. That's what I've been doing for the last 3 years, really. You don't get much time time to yourself when you're in a show like The Dinner Ladies.
As everybody knows, I'm an avid cyclist, so I'm always on my bike, no pun intended. I like A Quiet Night at Home with a Joan Crawford DVD. I like a bottle of red. The simple pleasures in life. You know, the odd whiff of amyl, a gentleman caller, something like that. Just to get you through the evening. That's what gets you through the night while I'm
I like to travel, like my Xbox. Sitting around the house. I like cooking. Fantastic cook, ex-chef.
What do you like to cook?
I like to cook lots of stuff. Stephen, don't ask me things like that, because I've got so many things I love to cook. I love Italian, I love desserts. I'm the queen of desserts. If there's ever a cooking show.
No, I don't. I am available. I have been looking. I am very sensitive. And please, I don't want to spend this Christmas alone.
I've got a dear partner I've been with for, 26 years. I was 3 when we met. He knew I did drag when we met, and it's part of my life and part of his life, and he takes it on board. He's very patient and I'm very blessed to have him.
I'm currently single. I have been for just over 3 years now, which is quite a long time. But I am always open to the possibility of meeting someone. However, unfortunately, at the moment, I'm so super busy that I would feel like I wasn't doing it justice if I met someone. But in the future, I'm definitely looking out for someone. And when I was younger and people would say things about me being a drag queen, I would, you know, probably take it to heart more than what I would now. Like, these days, I don't even really think of myself as a drag queen. It just doesn't even factor into my vision of myself. So if someone was to have a problem with me being a drag queen, they wouldn't date me for that reason. I wouldn't even care. I would just think, well, obviously that person isn't for me because they're too narrow-minded and can't see me for who I am.
I've just recently got a boyfriend. I've been going with him for 7 months. His name is Wayne. He's a lovely man. He's the good thing about him is he's been on the scene and off the scene before me. So he's come to see me a couple of times, but he's not interested. He's done that already. He's been there, done that. And I've sort of kept doing drag because I didn't have anybody in my life, and now I do. So I'm sort of now ready to. I've had my fun with drag. I'm ready for my next chapter and to do explore, live, love with Wayne. So that's great. The funny thing was, he didn't know I do drag because you normally tell a guy that you're seeing you do drag on the sixth date because you normally don't get to the sixth date. So the first time I went to Wayne's house, he played me a movie, and the movie he played me was Kinky Boots, a movie about a drag queen. I thought, does he know? But he didn't know. It was just a coincidence. But he loved drag, and that's good. But he doesn't love drag in that way. He just respects, appreciates the drag. So we don't do that when I'm in drag.
Boyfriends come and go when it comes to drag. Some of them love it. I've had some... Oh, I can't say that. Some of them come, some of them go. Some of them hang around. I've got a lovely boyfriend at the moment. My husband. We're not married or anything like that. But, yeah.
What about...
But he doesn't mind. He loves it.
What a boyfriend. His name's Dean. We've been together for about 8 months. He's probably the first real boyfriend I've ever had. We do fight quite a lot, but I just think that's mainly because I'm a bitch. But I don't think he cares that I do drag. Like, he knew I did drag when we met, and to be honest, everyone thinks he's a loon, which is fine to me. But I don't think he cares. I do talk about it quite a lot, and I think he gets over it. I think he just blocks out anything I say, so I think that's fine. But we've been together for 8 months, and it's going all right so far, as long as I can get in a good mood once in a while.
No, I don't have a boyfriend. I do everybody else's boyfriend. I've actually, I've never really had a long-term relationship, not really. I've had things that have lasted for a couple of months, but I've never been lucky enough. And I think when you do drag and you're sort of high profile, I think it's really, really difficult. But there are some that have managed to do it and do it really successfully. But I haven't, and perhaps I'm the one that's sitting at the bar at the end of the night and asking the person who's sitting next to me, what's he doing for the next half an hour? That's my pickup line.
Taxi driver.
Or a taxi driver, failing that. Somebody who always looks after a damsel in distress.
I got a boyfriend, 4 years, celebrated it the other day, went up Groovy Tower. How fantastic was that? He loves me doing drag, as long as he doesn't come out though. I like him at home and me out doing this.
Well, I have a boyfriend to some people. Those lids that we don't like, the next guy next to you is your boyfriend, always. But no, very single, ready to mingle, young, dumb, full of cum, as Tabitha would say.
I do. I have a partner, a lovely partner. We have been together 11 years, and he is very understanding of the whole situation, but he prefers not to see it. Not to have anything to do with it. And when I'm lucky, I'm fortunate, he spends a great deal of time away with work. But when he's home in the house, I literally have to sneak up the back stairs, get changed in the kitchen, strip it off, and pretend like nothing happened. So it's a bit like a dirty little secret, which I kind of like.
So a loon, I think the story goes, when the lunar eclipse came out, when the moon was on a full moon, they'd say, well, the loons are coming out because of the moon.
So a loon is a straight or bi-curious man that's attracted to a drag queen or a cross-dresser. No, more a drag queen. Cross-dressing more submits into that fetish sort of category, more so a drag queen.
Loons at the end of the bar. Do you ever get people cracking onto you?
All the time, all the time. Especially on Facebook. They think that you're standing there at 9 o'clock in the morning looking like this, when you're sitting there in your pyjamas, a beer and a cup of coffee in your hand. And all they want to do is, oh, can you suck me off? No, it's 9 o'clock in the morning. I'm having my coffee. That was a while ago, though. That was a long time ago. That might have been MySpace. Oh, I can't remember. MySpace, Facebook. Loons are always there. They've always been there. They're an institution. Every girl knows loons. Mm. They love it. They love you to look like a girl, but they won't do balls.
Do they get you? Do they ask you to do things like?
Yeah.
Like what?
Do these things.
Like what?
It's happening around, isn't it? In the toilet.
Where are we now?
In the toilet. I've probably been over here before. Shh. We can't talk like that. Cut. Dirty, dirty things. Well, they come to your house. And you have a little tea candle and a really crappy wig on. You don't want to ruin your good hair in bed. I've done that before. I learned the hard way. A lace front. 6 hours in bed. Wasn't very pretty. Poor vanity wigs. This one I ripped. So yeah. They ask a little tea candle. A little bit of makeup. Your hair over here. And they think you're beautiful. Well, funny you should mention that. I really cannot really ride a taxi home without, you know, getting semi-molested. Like, honestly, Chilli, you have no idea the amount of times I've had to sit in the front just to get a bit of action. Oh, love. They're out there. They're everywhere.
Loon.
Fresh loons, cream pie, loonberry pie, cream, loons.
Well, my experience with the loon.
She likes the big one. She likes to. Maybe she's a chubby chaser.
Chubby chaser.
No.
I like a big tummy.
She does.
Yeah, this is a loon. I remember that when it's Three Faces is still on, I was doing the show down there. And this loon just crossed the traffic, like, you know, where Porter Street is. And he thought that I'm a girl. I said, coming down. And then he went to Three Faces on that time. And it was a present because there's still so many queen in there. And then you look at me, oh, come on. And after that, you know, and it was not like scared.
And what did she say?
I'm still shocked.
I was talking about three faces.
Yes, three faces.
Three faces.
She's a girl.
Yeah.
And that time, that loon, it became my husband.
Yes, see.
Every cloud has a silver lining.
Doesn't it, Chilli?
We got 10 years together, and then in the 90s, 2001, passed away on the 7th before Christmas. She's a lovely guy. I miss. But anyway.
Is that your current one?
Not the current one. That's the one who take a videos, you know?
Of course, if you Google me, when I was in my 30s, I was really pretty. Now I'm fat and hairy. But I was very beautiful. I still am in good light. That means when the light's turned off. But lots of men would be very intrigued and they'd want to play with me, sleep with me, or just experiment with me. I think they were curious. So I think some men can't accept the fact that they're gay, but with a drag queen or a transgender person, they feel more comfortable. And some of us use this as a springboard before they eventually end coming out. So they might play with the most beautiful showgirl to a drag queen and to a boy. And then some of them, it's just a fantasy of being with a boy that looks like a girl. So, and I've had lots of them. Lots.
Cool.
Maybe too many.
Don't fuck with me, fellas.
What about you, Rita? Did you get your loons trying to crack onto you?
Are you serious? No, not really, not generally. They don't like the clown drag. They don't go for it. Although I have had the.
I'm no, I was going to say.
I mean,
I've
been touched up with the peel. Who hasn't?
Yeah.
It's
not a good night. Let's be touched up.
And have you ever gone home with any of Loon's and done it in drag?
Years ago, yes, but not
as you do.
No. And the taxi drivers don't normally go for me anymore. Normally, when I get into a cab now, they start praying in Arabic when I'm sitting in the back. You know, I don't know what's going on with that. I don't think they like the homosexuals. So the days of getting a free cab ride and saying, you know, how about a bit of whatever or touching them up, whatever, they're gone.
They are.
You get in with your drag bag looking like this, and they just start praying to Allah.
That some of them even actually put on deodorant.
They're doing deodorant.
It's been known to happen.
No, me and Loons, nah, not a good mix. Sorry. That's all
that.
I can say there.
You're the queen, darling.
Thank you, darling.
You're the best.
Isn't that beautiful?
Oh,
you're from the horse to mouth.
Yes.
Beautiful boy. Here in the toilet. You meet some lovely people. A nice quality, I think. Like tiles.
Fuck with me, fellas. Time at the rodeo.